At 9:17, welcome back to News Channel 3 Live at 9. You can live like the millionaires do this holiday season.
Our hometown tourist travel writer Samantha Crespo takes us to Memphis's Millionaire Row to see how they're decking the halls this holiday. Thank you so much for being here, Samantha.
Sure, thanks for having me.
How fancy is it?
Oh my gosh, I had the best time touring the Woodruff Fontaine Mansion. If y'all have read the book, you know that I have a thing for old, grand old homes. So I toured Woodruff Fontaine last week, and there's something new there and something coming up. So first of all, for something new, this is a three-story mansion if you see it from outside. However, there is a beautiful tower front and center that extends the home's height to six stories.
Is it like the foyer? Oh my gosh.
No, I hope you aren't claustrophobic.
Is it that thing we see?
The front middle right there?
That's it. So then here's what's new. Up until this past fall, you could not go up in the tower. Fire department didn't like it. However, the home has made some accommodations. So you're able now to climb up into the top of this tower.
Is that where they kept like the crazy relatives like me? That's where they would have locked me up.
Are you the bat in the belfry, Mary Beth?
Yeah, I'm the bat in the belfry.
The cool thing about it is back in the 19th century, you would have been able to see from that tower clear to the river. Of course, that is not the case anymore, but you can look down on Molly Fontaine Lounge across the street. Another historic home, which was a wedding gift to the Fontaine's daughter, Molly. So December 17th through 20th, if you want to see the house bedecked in all of its holiday finest, Project Motion, which is a contemporary dance collaborative, is going to be doing performances on the grounds. Yeah, it looks like they're going to bring in a lot of decorated trees and do some maybe a performance in the backyard.
Nice.
So that's December 17th through 20th. The nice thing about that is the home will be open at night, so you'll be able to see it illuminated in all of its holiday beauty.
Is it kind of like period decorated as far as the...
Absolutely. And the neat thing about this house, not a lot of the furnishings are original, but when the home was taken over in 1961 by the Association for the Preservation of Tennessee Antiquities, they have since then been filling the home with the most ornate antiques, period clothing. And so whenever you visit this home, you're getting a new visit because they change all of those, the fashions out seasonally.
Cool.
And so there's always something new to see there.
So these are for people who want to get a frame of reference. This is Victorian Village over by Adams and...
Exactly, on Adams. And what I think is so neat, back in the 19th century, Memphis's millionaires were building their homes and the street earned its nickname, Millionaire's Row, there were 30 homes on the street. And so very few remain. But of course, next door to Woodruff Fontaine, you can also tour the Mallory Neely home. That's newly open. The first time I reported on it was just a few years ago, and it had been closed to the public for several years.
So it's been renovated.
And in fact, they just finished a window restoration project. 91 windows they had to restore.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
Imagine.
And they didn't put
that's
like
a lot of
brand
Windex.
New.
That's
a lot
of Windex. You know. I can't imagine having to clean all those. But that home is unique among Memphis's historic homes because most of its furnishings are original and belong to those families.
So if you're like a Downton Abbey fan, go and tour. You would love this kind
of thing. They're absolutely grand.
Cool.
Fantastic.
Don't lock me in the belfry.
I would never.
She would. He says never for TV. Thanks, Samantha. For more great ideas from Samantha, pick up a copy of her book, 100 Things to Do Before You Die in Memphis.